Hello everyone, I am Nushirwan and today I will talk about CSC scholarship and more specifically I will talk about acceptance letter. I have lots of questions from students. They were asking me how to get acceptance letter, why they need acceptance letter, and can they apply without acceptance letter or not. I will talk about all these things in this video, and if you have any questions related to CSC scholarship or acceptance letter or anything that is related to study in China, you can reach me out on my Instagram and you can directly talk to me. I will reply all your questions. The link of my Instagram will be mentioned in the description. Similarly, I will have some templates, some samples of emails which you can write to professors, and also some templates of acceptance letters if a professor asks you to send him the template or sample so that he can just input your name and details and he can send you back. So for those samples, you can also check in the description. So the acceptance letter is for those students who need a supervisor for their research. For example, master students and PhD students, when they will do the research, they will write their thesis, they will need a supervisor. So they can reach out to those professors who can supervise you. And better write to full professors, not go for assistant professor or associate professors, because in most universities they will not be able to supervise you. Mostly full professors are supervising students. In some cases, some universities, associate professors are also supervising students, so you can make sure before sending them an email that they can supervise you. Secondly, it's not for bachelor students, that is undergrad students, because they don't need a supervisor when they are applying for a scholarship or for their degree program in bachelor's level. So let's talk about how to get acceptance letter. The first step you need to do is you need to find out university in which you want to get admission. And for that, you can go to official website, www.campuschina.org. This website have complete list of universities and the programs offered by those universities. On this website, you can also find the list of programs that you can apply. You can also find the list of scholarships that you can apply. All the scholarships that are available in China are mentioned on this website in detail. So the first thing you need to do is go through this website, find out university in which you want to apply. The second step, you can go to the website of university and try to find out the list of professors. So there are two types of website. One is in which you can find out all the list of professors from different departments at one place, maybe on one page. And in some websites, you can find the faculty list, maybe inside the list of departments or something like that. Anyways, so go to the website, explore the website completely, and try to find out faculty list. Once you get the faculty list, then you need to shortlist the professors who are from your department and who can supervise you. They should be professors, not associate professor or the assistant professor. In some cases, as I mentioned before, associate professors, they can supervise you, but in most cases, you should look for full professors. Once you find the professors list, then you can go to specific professor who is relevant to you, and you can find his email or his contact. Sometimes their WeChat ID is given there. In most cases, their email will be mentioned over there. So what you need to do is you need to contact them via email, or you can text them if their WeChat is available. If their phone number is available, you can call them during their working hours. So you can check out what is time in China. So according to that, you can reach out to them. In lots of cases, on websites, the details of professors are not given, like contacts are not mentioned over there. Only maybe their names and pictures are available, but no contact email or phone number is available. So in that case, you can try to ask international office if they can provide you the list of their contact. And I think they will not provide you in most cases. So for those universities in which their details or their contacts are not available, you can apply without acceptance letter. So there is no problem about that. If their contact is not available, just straight away go and apply for the scholarship. But for those universities in which their contact details are available, I will strongly recommend you to write an email to them and try to get an acceptance letter. If they don't reply your email, which happens in most of the cases, then you don't need to worry about it. Maybe they are not interested in your profile. It's maybe they did not get your email. Maybe they don't supervise any more students. Maybe they are not just replying you. They never read your email. Anything can happen. So just keep on trying. And if you don't get acceptance letter, then apply without an acceptance letter. It's not a mandatory document. It's just an optional document. And if you get an acceptance letter, it increases the chances of your scholarship. If you don't have acceptance, I have lots of examples of students. They don't have acceptance letter and they applied without acceptance letter. They got the scholarship. So chances are good. Don't worry about it. And if you don't find any contact, just apply without acceptance letter. Now let's talk about what is the right time to contact those supervisors or writing an email to those supervisors. Well, there is no specific time for that. But I recommend some time or some duration in which you should reach out to them when they are available most of the time. So this is month of October. The first week of October is national holidays in China. So I strongly recommend you not to write an email or contact supervisor during national holidays because they will not reply you. They will not reach out to you at all because they are off. They are busy with their families, so they are not on campus at all. What you should do is the right time for sending an email is after 8th or 10th of October. They will be back to school and they will be checking their email. So from October 10th to end of December, I mean before the Christmas season, you should write emails to professors and try to influence them and ask them or request them for the acceptance letter. That is the right time, I think. There is no other time I would suggest. Some students, they usually request them in January or February. Again, I would recommend that February is not the right time because it's Chinese New Year, and during Chinese New Year they will be off and they will not reply you at all. So in January you can write them email, but the most suitable time is between October to December. Now let's talk about writing an email and getting acceptance letter. This is the most important part which decides if you can get acceptance letter or not. So the first thing is email. That should be very direct, to the point, and written in very simple English. It should not be long so that professor don't read it. Most of the time, professor open the email, they find a long email, and they just go back. They ignore the email. So make sure that you are writing a short email, to the point, and with specific points that are related to you and which should be mentioned on that. The first thing that you should mention on your email is your introduction. Introduction should be very brief. You should not talk about what you have done in your bachelor's, in master's, and now you're applying for PhD. So very brief, your name, from where you did your last degree, mention about the name of university, and then start talking about your research, what you have done. This research is the most important part. So you should write most of the things about your research work. If you have done any research work in your past experiences, you should mention about that. If you have published any paper, mention their title and mention in which journal you have published. Don't write the whole abstract and stuff like that. Just mention the title. If you have attended conferences, just mention the title of the paper that you have presented in the conference. And if you have not attended any conference or you have not published any research paper, then you can talk about what research that you have done or what thesis that you have written for your previous degree. And you can just mention the title of that thesis. And then in the next part, you should talk about your research interest and why you are writing to that specific professor. Here, when you're writing about your research interest, make sure that your research area aligns with the professor's research area. So if you're writing to a professor who is similar in your research area, then you have the most chances to get the acceptance letter. So in the email, mention about your research interest, why you want to research with that specific supervisor. And you can mention that I have read your previous papers or your previous publications, and those are most relevant to you, and that's why you are writing to that professor. And in the next step, you can request for acceptance letter, and they know that you are requesting for acceptance letter because you are applying for a CSC scholarship. So just mention that you need a acceptance letter to apply for that mission or to apply for the CSC scholarship. And in the last part, you can mention about your details, like if you are a student, or if you are working for someone, or if you have any work experience, just one line. And maybe if your email is already long, you can skip this part and then just finish thank you. And you can mention that you have attached your documents along with the email. Lots of people, they ask me what documents they should attach with the email. Two most important documents that you should attach. One is your CV or your resume, and the second is your research proposal. If you don't have research proposal, you can just ignore. You must attach your CV. I'm sure every student who is applying for the scholarship, for master's degree program or for PhD, they must have a CV. So you must have an academic CV, not a CV that is related to the work. So if you are applying for a job, you need a different structure of the CV. But when you are applying for a academic scholarship, you should have an academic CV. So for the academic CV, I have a template. You can ask me and I will send out to you. In the CV, you should mention more about research and your research interest, what you want to do, what projects you have done before, what research you have published before, and what research you will work in future. So CV is very important to attach with your email. And the second thing, which I said you can ignore, is research proposal. But if you have research proposal already with you, you should attach. In the next step, when you have already sent the email, then maybe after a few days, you get a reply from that supervisor. And usually what happens is they have some counter questions from you. Let's say they ask you about your publication. Maybe they send you some interview questions in which they ask what are your research interests, why you want to do research with him, and if you join the university, what will be your research topic or what topic you will write thesis on. And if you get a question like that, then you should be very optimistic. It's a very positive sign, and I'm sure that that supervisor has read your CV, your email, and has checked your research proposal. So after reading that, he may be asking you some counter questions. So you need to be very conscious about it and take your time, write a detailed answer. And there is no right or wrong answer, but make sure that you answer to the point. And these answers can be in detail. I will not say write a short answer or something like that. But if a professor is asking you, like, why you want to do research work with him specifically, then you can write his previous research publications, and you can say that you have the similar research interests. You can mention about your proposal. You can also mention about some of the literature review that you have and which you think that is very relevant to him. And then you can say, okay, that is the reason that I want to be your student. And in this way, like, he can decide if he want to go further with you or not. At the end, I think I have covered almost all the basic things about acceptance letter. But still, if you have any confusion, if you have any question, you can ask me directly on my Instagram or on my Facebook. The links are given below in the description, and I will reply you. And yep, that's all. I have many other videos related to CSC scholarships and studying in China. And if you want to watch them, you can follow me and you will get the videos often. And if you have any question, you can reach out to me. Thanks for watching.